I know that Paradox has some experience with the Phonon matchup. Okay. One of the people that he was rooming with plays Phonon, so I got to imagine has some experience. And it's a pretty common character, a pretty popular character, I should say. I don't want to say common and make it sound like low grade. Popular is a more more positive spin on it.
We can't be doing Corey like that.
No, no. I mean, far be it. No. And Phonon was one of the characters that I eyeballed for a little bit playing in this game. I didn't quite click with her in the end of it. I tend to like characters that can play more of a spacey, zony game. But Phonon didn't quite click with me.
Yeah, yeah, same thing for me. Because I used to play Merkava, I spent a little bit of time with Phonon thinking about picking her up. And then I just realized I actually just like Yuzu too much.
Nah, Yuzu's super cool.
She's so fun. She's so fun.
I can't play her too much. I'm not good with... Because that's you have to do some negative edge stuff with her, right?
Oh, yeah, there's a little bit of that. I feel like although she is one of the more difficult characters in the game, I feel like the difficulty is a bit overstated.
Gotcha.
Is a reachable goal to get good with her.
So we got Phonon versus Hyde here. I got to imagine. Yep. I got to think that this one's in Phonon's favor. That's my thought, but let's see how it plays out here.
Yeah. Hyde definitely has better options than Mika.
I'm not sure how I feel about Hyde sacrificing that space though off the bat. That feels a little bit too much respect being shown, but it looks like it's working out okay here. There's the corner, little bit of corner carry here. God, doesn't Hyde just corner carries off of everything?
Oh yeah, oh yeah.
It's like cool. I get 3K damage and corner carry off of every combo. Love it.
And right now, Phonon doesn't have meter, so she just doesn't have a reversal.
Yeah, but look at all that grid that Phonon has, though. That's like 8 blocks of grid. That's probably about 100 meter if that gets cashed out.
Yeah.
Like honestly, I'm kind of cash it. Oh yeah, look at that fill up. Beautiful.
Oh yeah.
So
all that meter.
Catches with the 2-2C as well.
Got hit by the overhead? Oh, no.
That's a
bad luck.
That's an extremely bad tell, especially this early in the matchup, because now Corey knows that that can work on Paradox.
Yeah, for sure. Went for the 63B there. Was blocked, but she just has all this real estate to back up. Take all the time she wants.
What's the fireball called from Hyde? Orbital or Orbital Edge or something like that?
I forget. I'm going to call it Fireball.
Cool. Love it. Nice and easy. Stick with the classic.
It's not called Orbiter?
Orbiter might be right. I'm going to call it Fireball. I'll be honest with you. Just being completely real. Completely honest with myself.
Orb Ball.
Ooh, Orb Ball.
Catches it.
Excellent EX Orb Ball.
Yeah, catches that. Doesn't quite get the pickup off of it afterwards, though. So not ideal situation there.
Got the damage, but not the
All right, Paradox. I see you trying to focus up a little bit more, but getting caught by Corimon. Corey's going to be able to get the life lead out of this one and wins the Vorpal Cycle that round. Blocks the... what is it? That's the 66C was the overhead from Phonon here?
Charge 66B. I think she might have actually done the uncharged one. But yeah,
okay.
Corey's having she's having some drops here and there, but she's still maintaining control regardless.
Yeah,
and,
it's like while there is a couple of drops here and there, the basement level performance is like the base level performance of what's happening is still excellent.
Absolutely. And
stability.
Yeah,
that's the word I'm looking for.
Yeah. That's a good one. I like that one.
Yeah, the Corey's game plan is still extremely stable here, where there's not much flux to it, and it's not like she's suddenly cracking and having a problem with it once a combo drops.
All right, I apologize. I had the name wrong there.
Stardust.
There we go. That makes more sense. I thought the Paradox was the other player there.
Yeah,
and the winner of this is going to have to fight White Beast.
Woo! That's a rough one. But yeah, Stardust is actually one of the a Michigan player from the west side of the state. Plays with Shinakira, also a Hyde player.
Okay. So Corey here is getting corner carried a little bit. Has enough meter for a reversal. Ooh, invalid combo. Come on, Corey. Nice. Wow. Goes for the immediate veil off to get that to get back in control of the board there. Catches with a 2-2C
Once again, got hit by the overhead there. Just trying to block it low.
If you see that screen flash and you're fighting a Phonon, get to blocking high.
Yeah.
You can block it high on the screen flash react, right?
Oh yeah. No problem. You just got to know about it and you got to remember.
Yep. Yeah, a way to try to handle that sort of stuff in this game too is if you know that if there's a screen flash, whether or not there could possibly be a low, you can just block high afterwards. Or vice versa. It's one of those things that, like in fighting games, not just in this fighting game, but how you make your decisions easier by just removing necessary reactions and just knowing I only have to do it this way. Corey takes that one pretty handily and down to like 15 seconds too in the round.
Yeah, and we're actually already on match point here.
I like that. Gets overhead there and then hits the orb ball.
Yeah, this is Stardust going in. Definitely time to make something happen.
Yeah, hasn't got a round yet, so I'd like to see at least a round from Stardust. Otherwise, I might have to give him some guff after the game. Not that Corey's not a great player, of course, but you got to give your friends a hard time if they know how they do. Phone on here, keeping away, channeling that grid. Ooh, the dash up gives just enough grid to win the Vorpal cycle. That was really good on Stardust's part. Corey, though, trying to bring things back to stable and trying to slow stuff back down and keep it back to where she wants things to be. This beautiful extension on this combo here. Ooh, casual 4.1K for the meter. Love it. Nice.
Fun.
That shield there was able to get this Vorpal, but then tried to CS and make a move with the invincibility off the CS. Didn't quite work out, though.
Yeah, at that range.
Wow, gutsy DP.
But
that was the right call, though, because Corey absolutely wanted to close that out there because she was getting so close to finishing it. So I think having the read that Corey was going to go for the offense again gets the shield break. Interesting.
Well, yeah, Corey almost ran all the way back that round. Almost denied Stardust even one round.
Yeah.
Like Stardust was on the verge of closing it out and then just had a combo drop where he didn't get the Oki.
Yeah, and then it turned into like two full sequences from Phonon.
Yeah. That's all it takes.
Especially with Phonon too, because you can't be as risky in your gameplay since you can confirm from anywhere. So like you really have to be careful versus Phonon.
Yeah, for sure.
Not able to get anything else off of that. Oh, nice.
Just counter hit there.
This is going to be probably around 3K. Oh, drops. I feel like that was a premature drop. That might be it. No, another premature drop. Oh, come on, Corey.
She's dropping, but she's in control, honestly.
Yeah, that's one thing I really like, is that even if she drops a combo, she's immediately back on the game plan. She doesn't have any, like, downtime. Like, no, like, oh, God, I dropped it. Reel back.
Yeah, just...